back to GCT Academy and Making Golf Your Thing. I'm Chris.
And I'm Arnie.
And we just showed you how to fix a divot or a ball marker. Apparently that's a thing now. But we are going to show you how to make a divot or a ball marker. So to do so, just a few things. This is called the leading edge of the golf club. This is the face of the golf club, and these are the grooves. That's going to be pretty important just to understand how spin and what makes the ball spin. So, doing so, we want to have this leading edge hit down on the golf ball, and what this golf ball does, it rolls up on the face and catches these grooves and causes backspin. What that will do is when the ball hits the green, you're actually going to create a depression on the golf ball or on the green, and the ball would actually be able to spin back. So, to do that, you can see how my shaft lean, you see the leading edge there, needs to be in front of that club face. There's a difference between that and that. We're going to try to get your club to be looking that way at impact so the ball can hit down, roll up on the face, and cause spin. Arnie's going to show you how his arms and what your setup should be looking like to hit down on it.
So like Chris said, whenever we set up to a golf shot at impact, we want to make sure that our hands are in front. We've got this business card here to kind of show. Chris can help me out here.
It's Zeke Connors.
At impact, when we come down, in order for our club head to be parallel with that business card, if you can tell, my hands are in front of this golf ball. And that's super important, like Chris just described, for this ball to use these grooves. It's why we have them on irons and not on woods, because they have to work up more of them, and they're going to go right up the club face like this. So one thing we talk about with setup, and I see a lot with amateurs, is when they set up, in order to stay somewhat comfortable, they keep their hands behind the golf ball. And what that's going to do is encourage them to keep their hands behind the golf ball. And like we just explained, a good setup is probably going to mimic impact. So if we set up with our hands a little bit in front, I'm able to return it right back in front.
And then you'd also be able to, when the shaft goes behind the golf club, you actually loft up the club a little bit more.
That's right.
That's where you're going to lose a lot of distance. And when you get the shaft in front, you can see how it de-lofts the club as well. One last thing that we're going to kind of address is your grooves. If your grooves have dirt, if it has grass or has any sort of material in it, that's going to cause the ball not to grab it. You grab the grooves, it causes the ball for less spin. So if your clubs are dirty, generally you're not going to get a lot of backspin. But what everybody's been waiting for to see Arnie hit a great golf shot.
Here we go. Like we just explained, we're going to stay balanced. We're going to set up with a position that we want to have an impact. Then we're
going to
give a go at it.
That's really nice.
Wow.
So we're going to try to keep the shaft in front of you, get that leading edge to work for you, and get your grooves to work for you as well. We're starting a new junior golf academy here at GCT. On Saturdays, 9 a.m., 10 a.m., and 11 a.m. Sign up. We got a few kids already signed up.
Come and see us. Remember, clean those clubs.